Blog Talk Radio.
Hello, everyone. This is Lori Smith on Blog Talk Radio. Good evening. Merry Christmas to everybody. And this is Mount Bethel Christian Bible Study, Getting Real with God. And we're on for 30 minutes. It's a live internet streaming radio broadcast from blogtalkradio.com. Chat room is not open. I didn't bother to put the chat room up, but I just want to talk tonight about the Lord and what He's doing in my life and what God's doing in my life that I just like to share with people. You know, it's a beautiful thing. We're celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ. And, you know, this is the day that we celebrate it on for many reasons. If you go back and study it out, you can find out why. It's not just a pagan holiday. there's reasons why it was picked for this day to celebrate Jesus' birth. And it's awesome, it's amazing, and it's wonderful. And I'm glad that He came into the world. You know, light came into the world, praise God. And light came into my life, and I'm so thankful that the Lord Jesus saved me. Praise God, He came to save sinners, and He came to save sinners like me. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. And that was May 22nd, 2007, so I'm not looking back, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, I'm so thankful that He came for me. And, you know, I just like to talk about what He's doing in my life. You know, I wasn't a Christian, and I really didn't like Christians, and I didn't like the whole idea of Christianity because I'd met some really horrible Christians. And, you know, my dad was a Christian, and he was a horrible man. And Christianity to me just didn't seem all that great of a thing, but I knew who Jesus was, and I loved Jesus. And I always loved Jesus, and always had love in my heart for Him, and always knew what He did on the cross. So I grew up in a Western culture, so obviously knew this stuff from as a child. So I didn't have any problem believing that, but I just had a problem with God, you know, because I couldn't believe that God would let all these horrible things happen to me and people around me, and I didn't understand. You know, I was just uneducated in the things of God, and you know, when I was born again, May 22nd, 2007. And I received the Lord Jesus as my Lord and Savior, and I just opened up my heart to Him. You know, everything changed. You know, I was just, I wanted to learn. I wanted to learn what God's truth was, you know. Before that, I would never have opened up a Bible. I would have never, I did try to read the Bible periodically in my lifetime, and really just got, I couldn't get past the names, you know, in the first few pages of the Bible, either Genesis or Matthew. Also, I really couldn't get into it because I was blinded to it. I understand what the scriptures say now, you know, but I was blinded to it and I wasn't able to receive it because I wasn't able to receive Him. And until I was able to receive Him, I wasn't able to receive the truth. And so my eyes were open to the truth, you know, and I was like, oh, I could see the truth. I could see the lie that had been placed before me that I had been living before I was born again. Praise God. Hallelujah. And so I'm so thankful to be, you know, living really in God's kingdom now, even here on the earth, you know what I mean? It's awesome, you know what I mean? I cry because people don't believe, you know what I mean? It brings tears to my eyes. It really does to think that there's, because I was one of them. I was one of those people that would not accept Jesus as my Lord and Savior, and I wasn't ready to, you know, before May 22nd, 2007, and people would pray for me, and they'd be like, oh, these are nice people, you know, over the years, and be like, well, we're praying for you, and you know, you just call out to Jesus and He'll be there for you. And I really kind of took offense to that sometimes. And other times I was like, oh, well, they're just nice. They're just being nice, you know. But I didn't appreciate prayers, you know. And now I'm like, you know, praise God, those people prayed me in. You know, hallelujah. And I believe that. I really do. I think people were praying me into the kingdom, praise God, a long time ago. And people that I probably didn't even really think about or know very much about have probably been praying for me since I was born. So, you know, I believe that this all, you know, came to pass exactly at the time that it was supposed to. And I believe there's a reason for everything, and it's a part of God's plan, you know. So, yeah, God is just so good. Hallelujah. So, yeah, I'm not going to kind of go into talking about the birth of Jesus Christ. I mean, everybody can read the Bible for themselves and read that. You know, it's just a beautiful thing, you know, that God came down in the flesh as Himself, you know. Sent Himself, you know, as His Son, to go to die on the cross, you know, for us, you know, and it's like it was the only way that could happen. And people don't understand because they don't read the scriptures. You know, there's a whole lot of misconceptions out there for you know, why did they kill Jesus? It's like, well, somebody had to kill Him. He had to go to the cross and He had to die a certain way in order for this whole thing to take place. And He had to go down to hell and He had to become sin and take all of our sin. And become sin in order to be the final sacrifice and to take all of the sin of the world upon himself and become sin in order to justify this whole thing, to make it right, you know what I mean? And so, you know, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And he came out all victorious. Praise the Lord. The devil is done. His days are just about over. And, you know, praise God. Hallelujah. Jesus is all victorious. Amen. And so, you know, we have his victory. And what I really want to talk about here tonight really has everything to do with that. You know, we have his victory. We can live, you know, in this victorious life, really, here while we're still on the planet. We're supposed to be doing that. We're supposed to be trying to be more Christ-like. And becoming victorious just doesn't mean about winning or, you know, what victory means to most people. You know, like victory, like, I don't know, worldly goods and stuff like that, or just living a victorious kingly life or something. I don't know. But it's victory over temptations, victory over evil, victory over things that we know are from the devil, you know, evil stuff, you know. We can live godly here. We can live godly lives, and that's the victory that Jesus won. Praise the Lord. And really, that's what we're supposed to be doing. And so that's why, you know, I'm always in the Bible searching out, you know, the scriptures, because I'm trying to learn how to be more Christ-like all the time. And certain things that I've done, you know, since becoming a Christian have really kind of made me have to sit back and wonder, wow, what was my motivation for that? And, you know, was I really thinking about, was I really doing what God wanted me to do? Or was it just something I thought God wanted me to do, you know, or that God would be pleased with or whatever? You know, it's hard. It's a hard road to walk, because sometimes we might feel that we have confirmation from the Holy Spirit, you know what I mean, that oh, yes, this is exactly what I'm supposed to be doing, and it may not be exactly what we're supposed to be doing. We're supposed to be really seeking God all the time. I got confirmation from him, from the Father, a couple of days ago. I was praying really quite heavy in the Spirit. And I do spend a lot of time doing that. And I don't have kids or anything, right? So I'm not, when my time is my time. So I do have, like, lots of time to do this kind of. And I was just praying, and I just felt God, I just felt a confirmation, you know, that God was saying, you know, that I'm actually going in the right direction, and that I am supposed to be doing all of what I'm doing right now, and that he'll provide, because he always ends up telling me that he will provide. And that's, you know, that's really what this whole thing is all about. You know, we have to not be our own gods. We have to stop trying to be our own gods, and we have to let God be God and have faith. And a lot of people just don't want to do that, because it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work to sit back and be patient and have faith when we think, oh, no, you know, it's not going to happen. You know, doubting God, doubting God's word, it's not going to happen. It's never going to come to pass. And so, you know, especially when we're on a mission for God and we're thinking, oh, we're doing what God wants us to do and it doesn't seem to be working out, it's like, well, when is it going to work out? You know, patience is everything, and faith is everything. We have to remain in faith and remain patient, because it'll come to pass when God's perfect timing, you know, puts it together so that it can come to pass at the right time. And so this is lessons, you know, that I'm trying to learn, right? And just living victoriously. I mean, as far as that goes, you know, we can overcome. Jesus overcame. You know, he says, I have overcome the world. I have overcome. You know, you can overcome through me, in me, with me, you know. That's what we're supposed to be doing. We're supposed to be overcomers, you know. And so, because we know, looking around. See, I'm not one of these Christians who are kind of blinded by the truth, you know what I mean? Like just living in my own little private heaven, you know, while the rest of the world is suffering here. Because I take the scriptures very seriously, and Jesus says, you know, like, I mean, you know, who are you? You didn't come see me when I was sick. You didn't come visit me. They were like, well, when were you sick? When were you in prison? You know, and he was talking about any of my brethren. You know, we're supposed to be helping people, you know, and we're supposed to be doing all we can within our means and within our what God blesses us with, you know, to help people. You know, it's not really all about, oh, me, and what am I going to get, and what do I want? And, you know, it has everything to do with helping people, because in blessing other people, we're blessed, right? And so in giving of ourselves and helping people who are suffering, who are out, who are down and out, and who do need Jesus, they need a Savior, praise God. Those are the people we're supposed to be helping. And I went to quite a few churches that were talking about, because I live downtown Calgary, And some of these churches, you know, they don't want some of the homeless people coming into the churches. And they were like, well, we got to be careful who we let in here. And I was just like, I am so out of this church, you know. I am not going to stay in a church with people who profess to be the body of Christ, who will not help a homeless person and not even offer a cup of coffee to them and a chance to hear the scriptures, you know, and to meet the Lord. I mean, my God, like, that's the people you want in your church. You want people in there who need a Savior. You want people in there who are down, who are out of hope, you know, because that's who Jesus came for. You know, praise God, hallelujah. I was out of hope. I was out of everything. I was out of life. I was dead, you know. And Jesus came for me. Praise God. That's exactly who he came for. You know, he didn't come to save the righteous, like he said. He said, I came to save the sinners. I came to save those who are lost. You know, and he says, you know, they hear my voice, and they'll follow me. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. And because I was in hell. I was in darkness, you know. And so, like, I'm so thankful, so grateful to Jesus, praise the Lord. And so, yeah, it does grieve my heart when people don't believe in Jesus. Like, it's easy for me to believe in Jesus because I've met him twice that I know of now. Actually, you know, I've actually spiritually met him twice. And just amazing, you know what I mean? Like, I met him in a car when I had a car wreck, and I was going up. I was literally dying. I was actually leaving my body, and I could see my body. I could see the top of the car and all my friends in the car. And I started to turn to look up, and I was going up, which I was very happy about, that I was going up. And it was the right direction, really. So I was very happy about that. And I was relieved. It was a sense of relief for me. I was 18 years old, and I was doing a whole lot of drugs, and I had just been abused for 18 years of my life, and I was just dead spiritually. I was happy to see this situation happening before me, you know. I was heading towards the light, and a hand came down, and it was Jesus. I know it was. And he said, go back. It's not your time. So I packed my body, and then I woke up. I was talking to one of the police officers just for a couple of seconds and passed out again, but I'll never forget that. I met him there, and I also met him again when I was born again, May 22nd, 2007, in my apartment. Praise God. And so it's easy for me to believe in Jesus, you know what I mean? But it's better, it's even more beautiful when somebody believes when they haven't met him, you know what I mean? And just believes out of pure faith, you know. To me, that's just beautiful. And I hear from God quite a bit, and people say, well, that must be great. And it's like, yeah, but it's even better to have faith when you haven't heard from God, because that's true faith, you know what I mean? Like, praise the Lord, you know. I mean, my God. So this is the thing, hallelujah. You know, God is so good, and it grieves me that people don't open up their hearts to him, but I was in the same boat. I wouldn't open up my heart to him till I was ready. And, you know, that's okay. I was always thankful when people wouldn't push me to try to get me to open up my heart to God. I needed to do it on my own time, you know. I needed to open up my heart and give my life to Jesus Christ on my own time when I was ready to do it, you know. And so I'm thankful, you know, that there were some people in my life who didn't push me and, you know, into trying to serve God. And they were just like, well, when you're ready, you know, you just call upon him and he'll be there. And, you know, sure enough, he was. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And so, yeah, he's just been showing me some beautiful things, you know, in his word. And I've been doing a whole lot of Bible study and working on an associate's degree. And I'm working on a biblical counseling degree now, an ANC certified counselor, nephetic counseling. And also really studying out faith therapy and stuff. There's some great information out here for people. See, what my main focus point is that, you know, we can live in victory because Christ is victorious. Praise God. Jesus Christ is all victorious. Amen. And, you know, he said to the disciples when he was leaving, he was going up to the Father, he said, you go out in my name and you cast out the devil. You heal the sick. You free the oppressed. You know, you do all these things in my name, you know. And so, you know, we're supposed to be doing these things in Jesus and, you know, for the glory of, you know, of God and through with the help of God working through us with the Holy Spirit to help people, right? And so I thought, you know, what better way for me suffering along after being abused and having so much problems dealing with things in my life, you know, with the issues of psychological damage and just emotional damage done to me, I had to really learn fast. You know what I mean? How to change this stuff. And so it's taken me 5 years, which people would say, man, that's a long time. But I only have so much time to study on it. I only have so much time to work through it because I work full time, and I'm also, you know, I have a relationship with my sweetheart who's terminally ill. She's very, you know, he's very sick, and you know, he's end stage, right? So, you know, we're trying to live out the rest of his days, you know, while we're together. And you know, it's, you know, I'm busy, right? So I do have a lot of stuff going on, and so I can only do the healing portion of my work on my allowing the Holy Spirit and allowing stuff that I find to work through my healing journey from being abused as a child, right? So it has taken me a long time, but sometimes people say it takes a lifetime, and maybe it does, you know. But the issue is I've learned so much over the last probably 6 months, and that's just mainly because I've been doing, I thought, hey, the counselors, and the Christian counselors, well, I'm a Christian, right? So obviously I'm going to be looking into that. You know, they know. They're out here helping people. So they must have some answers. So what I started to do was look at what it is to be a counselor and what it is that people need. Instead of looking at it as a victim's point of view and going in and searching out stuff that way, I looked at it the other side, and I started to go in to look at how I could help myself and allow God to help me through the Holy Spirit and the Scriptures and other people that have come into my life, Beverly Searle and different people, Kate Mitchell, and people that have really helped me out with my healing journey. And some of them aren't even Christians, and they totally, you know, they don't profess to be Christians, but they do know who God is. And it's pretty amazing who God will put into your life. You know what I mean? I mean, amen, praise God. And so it's been a most amazing journey this last 5 years. I have a really bad cold, so hopefully you can understand what I'm saying. But it's just been so amazing. Like, I've been learning so much behind the scenes of looking at what counselors do, because I feel the Lord has moved me to become a biblical counselor, because he did tell me that we'll help his children. And he knows I've suffered in my lifetime, and I know that people are suffering. I mean, I went just recently to a place here in Calgary for women, and, you know, I won't name names, but there's people out here who are suffering. You know what I mean? There's people out here who are being abused, people out here who are being mistreated, people out here who are being, you know, taken advantage of, treated horribly, and, you know, they need help, you know, men and women, right? And they need our help. They really do. And they need a kind hand on their shoulder. They need a kind hand, you know what I mean? And they need fellowship, and they need God, and they need Jesus in their life, you know what I mean? But my mission, I believe, is to help people out. And so God's, you know, giving me the direction to do this, right? And I thought, well, how could I do that, Lord, if I'm not healed? You know what I mean? Like, if I'm still having so many issues with my healing journey. So what God's been doing is allowing me to allow him and some other people and other information I got a hold of to counsel me, you know, so that I can move forward in this, you know what I mean? And so I can help other people, right? Because I understand now what my issues were, what my problems were, what I needed to work through. And it's been amazing, you know. Like, I mean, I would hope that if there's anybody listening to this who has just been struggling and just thinking, how am I going to, you know, how am I going to cope? How am I going to do this, you know? Ultimately, it is up to you, you know what I mean? You have to make the decision on how you're going to get better, and you have to actually take that step. That's really walking in faith, really. I mean, that's walking in faith to say, you know what? I believe that I'm going to be healed. Praise God. It's just like that woman who had the issue of blood in the Bible there, and she had that disease, and it was just, she had spent every dime that she had trying to get healed, and doctors and physicians couldn't heal her. She was just bleeding all the time, and she was just dying, and she said, oh, she says, you know, the prophet's coming to town, Jesus, and if I could just touch his robe, you know, if I could just touch his robe, I would be healed. So she ran through the crowds, well, basically crawled through the crowds, bleeding, and, you know, that was really a bad thing to be doing out there in that day and age, because that was something against the laws of the land of Judea. And so she made it to Jesus' robe, and she touched his robe, and then she did that in faith, you know. She took that step in faith, believing that if she just but touched his robe, she would be healed. And Jesus was like, turned around, who touched me? He knew somebody touched him, and he looked at her, and she said, oh, I touched your robes, Lord, you know. And he said, well, you know, she said, I believe that if I touch but your robes, I would be healed. And he said, go, thou woman, rise, you are healed, praise God, by your faith, amen. And this is the issue, you know. So I realized that, hey, God's word is truth, you know. And if God's word is truth and God says you will be healed, you know, because we're healed by Jesus' stripes, praise God, hallelujah, well, then it's true, right? Total healing is going to come upon me at some point, praise God. I'd like it to be here on this earth. And so, you know, I'm like, well, you know, if that's the truth, then there has to be truth in his word, and there has to be truth that I can get a hold of and understand. And I've also found someone outside of the Bible that's been very helpful for me. But what I did was I turned it around and turned it into my own stuff that helps me, Christian-based, you know what I mean? So what I did was I just took their concepts and turned it into Christian-based stuff, and it did work for me. But you know, the issue is that's what it is. I believe in God, and I can't believe anything else, you know. I believe in God, and I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and I believe in the Holy Spirit, and that's all I believe in, praise God, and God's word, you know. So that's it, right? That's what I believe in. So I'm pretty strong in my faith. I don't think you can budge me off of it. I'm pretty stubborn. And so, yeah, I know it works, and it's worked for me. It's helped me out a lot. Am I still sad? Do I still have days that I'm down? Well, yeah, of course, you know. Jesus didn't say, let's be all perfect, you know. Well, yeah, just follow me, and you'll have the best life ever. You know, Jesus said, follow me, and you're going to have problems. I mean, you know, no doubt about it. You know, you will suffer for the name, you know, for professing his name and carrying that cross and picking up that cross, that daily cross, and walking with him. You know, there will be suffering. There will be, but there will be suffering in the world. Like Jesus says, there will always be suffering in the world. And that's why he sent his disciples out, because he said, look, in my name, you go out, you cast out the devil, you heal the sick, you free the oppressed, because there's going to always be suffering while the devil is roaring around here like a lion, thinking that he's so great when he's been defeated already, praise God, hallelujah. And so, you know, the issue is, there's always going to be evil in men's hearts, right? Because there will always be men and women and other people who will follow the devil. And they won't follow Jesus. They won't follow love and try to do the right things. And the right things being the righteous things that God would have us do to live this godly life, which is to love our neighbors as ourselves and to love God first place. I mean, what is hitting people and kicking people and burning people's houses down and ripping people off? And what is backbiting and slander and calling people names and cursing people behind their backs have to do with love? You know, what is jealousy and envy have to do with love, right? That's all from the devil, right? And so when I'm on my healing journey and I'm thinking about the abuse that I suffered in my life and this whole idea of forgiveness and stuff, it's been a huge issue for me to let go of what the devil has placed before me, which was to hold and harbor the grudges that I had for so long. Because I love my family. I loved my parents very much. They did not love me. My mother hated my guts and used to tell me on a regular basis that she hated me. She wished I was dead and that... She was possessed. I totally believe that my parents were both serving the devil, and they thought they were serving God, but they weren't. And my dad, even today, he's mentally ill. So he loves God, he loves Jesus, but he's continually bombarded by the devil. You know, and he admits it, that he sees the devil all the time. And my dad's schizophrenic, borderline schizophrenic, right? So I mean, I do feel bad for him, but he's probably under spiritual attack all the time. But we've been praying for him for years, but he won't cast the devil out himself. And even when you tell him, cast out the devil, Dad, cast out the devil, he won't do it. And he's had exorcisms, you know. My dad's just like, what are you going to do? But I, you know, the whole issue is that he believes in God. He's a born-again Christian. Look at his life, miserable. He hurt his wife, he hurt his children, and he wasn't the only one. My mother hurt her children and hurt him too. And then the children just all went off to hell. You know, I mean, this was a horrible destruction of a family of nine people that should have gone so much better, you know. And the reason I bring up my story is because it's such a story of hell. You know what I mean? I mean, we really suffered under a lot of spiritual abuse and really horrible, horrible psychological abuse, physical abuse. And all of us were a mess because of it. And the reason why I bring it up is because this is how so many people live their lives. I know because I knew a whole lot of people in the same position. And so I know what this stuff does to people as young children. I know what it does to them as teenagers. I know what it does to them as adults. because most of the people I knew were living the same kind of lifestyle I was. And so I know what it is to be hurting and suffering and be without God and to be separated from God and to not have His blessing and to not have salvation and to not be born again. I know what it's like for on the other side of that. And, you know, now, you know, I've been suffering since I've been born again. That's what Jesus said. You will suffer. But the issue is that I can overcome because I have Jesus' victory. Praise God. So, you know, I mean, praise the Lord. It doesn't matter what's thrown at me. It won't matter to me because that's not, my life is no longer my own. Right? It belongs to the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. I exchanged my life for His, and He exchanged His life for mine. It's an equal, valid, lawful exchange. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And God accepted it, and God thought it was great. And, you know, I accepted it, and so I'm in the covenant. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, and I'm so thankful and forever grateful, you know. And I wish that for everybody, you know what I mean, that everybody would accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior. But some won't, you know, and that's really sad. But that's the way it goes. But anyway, the people out here who are hurting and suffering, man, they need help, you know. And so what I've been doing is working on some really awesome, looking at some great things from this one place. It's free Christian counseling training. But in it is some awesome truths from the Bible that you will not hear from just about anybody. I haven't heard it from anywhere. If you're a survivor of abuse, which most people who listen to my shows are, or you know somebody who has been abused as a child or abused in their lifetime, this particular website, I'm going to give you the website, is so awesome because it's called Faith Therapy. It's for people who are interested in counseling within the church, biblical counseling. But it's not your average biblical counseling. Oh, forget that you were ever abused and move on with your life. You know, it's not that. It's like, okay, now we're going to get to the root of the problems. And, you know, he really goes on to talk a whole lot about abuse and what it does to people in biblical terms, pointing out in the scriptures what God says about it and how horrible it is and that it, actually people who abuse children are guilty of murder, whether they murdered the child or not, because in God's eyes they have murdered that child, right? So my parents are both guilty of murder. But, of course, if they accept Jesus, they're forgiven. And they repent, you know what I mean? And they repent. You have to repent of your sins. You know, I had to repent of my sins, and I still do today, right? And that means to turn around and change it, you know. Ask for forgiveness from the Father. You know, try to make amends here on the earth, and then to change it, to repent, to turn around in the opposite direction and go the way that God would have us go, right? Now, did my parents repent? No, they really didn't. And that's really sad because they're going to face the judgment for sure. They're not going to face the judgment on the white throne judgment, but they're going to face judgment on the fact that they abused their children and did not feel bad about it at all. You know, they didn't care that they hurt us. They didn't care that they hurt each other. They were so full of hatred and so full of evil, right? But this website, freechristiancounselingtraining.com, Dr. Reiner is the one who puts this together. They have so many great teachings on here. It's all biblical-based, which is wonderful. And just everything. You don't have to be wanting to be a counselor to get some really great truths out of this stuff. What I'm working on becoming a biblical counselor, so obviously, and also a Christian life coach, so obviously I'm interested in it. But the thing is there's some beautiful truths here for people who, like myself, who have suffered and been abused as a child. Because what it does is it helps to put it in context in the Bible of where it says, you know, what should have happened, that it never should have happened, right? And we as a Christian, I need to know this. Obviously, I know this outside in the secular world, but as a Christian, I need to know this, you know what I mean? And really, it's great. There is some awesome truth in it. And Dr. Reiner, and it's from www.freechristiancounselingtraining.com. That's all one word, freechristiancounselingtraining.com. And it's called Faith Therapy. If you type in your browser, Faith Therapy, that might work too. It's Word of Life Counseling Training Institute. That's who puts this out. And you can get a degree. You can take the course for free, which is what I'm doing, for a certificate. Or you can sign up for the actual degree and get a diploma and get credits towards college or whatever. But you can do the free course, too. It's the same exact course. So they're just offering it to you for free. And you don't have to do all the work if you don't want credit for it. But if you do want credit for it, then you do have to pay for it. And you have to do all the work in it. It's not all that expensive, but it's amazing stuff, let me tell you. So that's one. I'm also doing some other great stuff with the BCF, Biblical Counseling, it's Emmanuel's Church. That's another great biblical counseling course, and looking at especially to do with NANC, Nuthetic Counseling. But it's just some really great stuff. So if you're interested, if you've been abused and you're having a hard time, there's some great truths in that, you know, and that God loves you and that God loves me. If he loved us enough to send his own son, his only begotten son, to die on the cross for us, that's how much he loves us. That's how much he cares about us. That's how much we're worth to him, that he would send his only begotten son to die for me. Praise the Lord. My God loves me, and he loves you, and he loves us the same as he loves Jesus. There's no difference. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And so, you know, you have a hard time, you just call out upon his name. You just call out to the Lord. You just call out to God, and you say, Father, I need you. I want you in my life. You know, come and surround me with your holy presence. And, you know, let him into your heart, you know, and let him into your life. Praise God. Light came into my life. May 22nd, 2007, not looking back. Have a great night, everybody. God bless you all. We'll talk to you real soon. Bye-bye.